Jarret Hurd says no matter what anybody says, I have the best resume at 154. Jarret Hurd learned quite quickly 8 months ago how just one close loss caused some fickle fans to suddenly discount virtually everything else you have accomplished. Hurd fell from one of the top two spots among the 154-pounders along with Jamel Charlo to an overrated afterthought. Once underdog, Julian Williams dropped and outpointed him in the IBF, IBO, WBA championship match May 11th in Fairfax, Virginia, when Williams was upset by an even bigger underdog, Jason Rosario, on Saturday night in Philadelphia. Hurd since to regain respect, even though he still hasn't fought since Williams beat him by unanimous decision in a 12-rounder 8 months ago. Hurd discussed the aftermath of his first fight, professional defeat, during an interview with Boxing Scene following a press conference Thursday in Brooklyn. "I learned something about these fans when I lost," Hurd said. "I wasn't even the one who beat Julian Williams, but now they are putting me back up in the rankings, saying that I have this chance and I have that chance. Before, when Julian Williams beat me, I was nothing. So I really don't know what the fans think, and I don't know where they rank me." Danny Garcia made the perfect statement a couple minutes ago. "The rankings are gonna be the rankings, and the politics are gonna be the politics. I'm just coming to fight." Still, unlike a lot of fighters, Hurd admits he pays attention to what's being said and written about him on the internet. "People say they don't, but you get notifications to your phone all day," Hurd said. "You know what I mean. From the fans and everybody, I don't let it get to me. But of course, I pay attention to it." The 29-year-old Hurd is fully focused, though, on rebounding from his loss to Williams on Saturday night at Barclays Center in Brooklyn. The former champion is unsightly a 50-1 favorite entering his 10-round fight against Francisco Santana. A tested and tough veteran who's basically been a welterweight the past 6 years. Showtime will air Hurd Santana as a part of the triple header that'll feature Philadelphia's Garcia, 35-2 with 21 KOs in the main event. A 12-round welterweight fight against Ukraine's Ivan Redcat, 23-4-1 with 18 KOs. Assuming Hurd, 23-1 with 16 knockouts, gets past Santana, a rematch with Williams, the fight Hurd had hoped to land next, no longer is a possibility. Williams stated right after Rosario stopped him in the fifth round at Temple University, Lacrosse Center, and he would exercise a clause in his contract for an immediate rematch. Hurd reiterated Thursday that he didn't take the immediate rematch with Williams, was contractually obligated to give him because he had a change of trainers from the longtime coach Ernesto Rodriguez to Kay Caroma. Kay Romea, you could get. Once Hurd passed on the immediate rematch, Williams was no longer bound to it. Now that Williams understandably is pursuing the Rosario rematch, Hurd isn't certain that will happen after facing Santana, 25-7-1 with 12 KOs. "I don't know," Hurd said. "The Williams-Rosario fight was a week ago. I always wanted a rematch with Julian Williams, but now I haven't even spoke to my team about it because we're focused on this. After the fight, maybe in a week or so." Hurd will welcome a showdown with WBC super welterweight champion Jermell Charlo. The fight, the Accokeek, Maryland native, expected to move toward had he beaten Williams 27-2-1 with 16 knockouts in one no contest. "That was always the biggest fight for me at 154. Before the whole mix-up," Hurd said. "I still think that's the biggest fight for me. So, I mean, hopefully I can get that fight. But it doesn't matter. Just want to get back on top as a world champion and build my legacy at 54 before I move up to middleweight." Hurd feels Charlo should embrace their bout because he, not Charlo, has accomplished the most among the active 154-pound boxers. "One thing for sure, no matter what anybody says, I have the best resume at 154, Hurd said. I defeated most of the guys. I'm the only one that stopped Austin Trout. And you know no one's ever had a win over Ilias Landry-Lara on their resume. I'm the only one who really beat Ilias Landry-Lara, who arguably doesn't have another loss." People argue about the Canelo fight and the results of a couple of Laura's fights, so I feel like I still have the best resume at 154. Hurd edged the Cuban-born Laura, 26-3-3 with 15 KOs by split decision, and in April 2018, their highly competitive clash, in which Hurd scored a 12-round knockdown, was voted Fight of the Year for 2018 by the Boxing Writers Association of America. Houston Charlotte, 33-1 with 17 knockouts. Avengers Loan lost to Tony Harrison last month by knocking him out. Harrison in the 11th round of their rematch. Charlo's impressive victory December 21st at the Toyota Arena in Ontario, California, enabled him to win back the title Harrison took from him almost exactly a year earlier when Harrison won a unanimous decision at the Barclays. Charlo also has beaten Trout, but their fight went the distance June 2018 in Staples Center in Los Angeles after Hurd had stopped Trout following the 10th round of their October 2017 battle at the Barclays Center. The 29-year-old Charlo hasn't fought Laura, the most accomplished opponent Hurd has defeated. Hurd has also stopped Harrison in the 9th round of their February 2017 bout at Legacy Arena in Birmingham, Alabama. Detroit's Harrison, 28-3 with 21 KOs, upset Charlo nearly 2 years after Hurd defeated him by a technical knockout. Boxing's other two 154 champions, the Dominican Republic Rosario, 21-1 with 14 KOs, and the Brazilian-born WBO title holder Patrick Teixeira, 31-1 with 22 KOs, have yet to make defenses of their respective titles. No matter whom Hurd fights next, Williams' loss Saturday night reinforced what we already knew, that he can't look past Santana. The 33-year-old Santana has a 6-round draw with Williams on his record. The Santana Barber, California native, has also lost an 8-round unanimous decision to Jermell Charlo in his following fight, both of which took place in 2011 when Santana first was a junior middleweight. "I've seen some tape on him," Hurd said. "He has a draw with a guy I lost to. First of all, so that makes him dangerous. Styles make fights, but you've got to keep that in consideration. He's been in there with guys who became world champions, like Julian Williams and Jermell Charlo, and he's got undefeated fighters on his record also." He has undefeated fighters on his record that he has also beat. He's a dangerous fighter, a dangerous opponent. He's coming to fight. You know he's not coming to lay down, so you've got to watch out for him. "If I don't get past this guy, rematches or getting my belts back or any of that stuff fall short. So I've got to make sure Saturday night that I do my fucking thing." What's up, fight fans? It's your man 3K the Boss, aka Mr. Two Hands Up. You know what it is. All right, fight fans, man, I'm going to just give it to you straight, man. This dude is the one guy at the PBC that I can't ever shit on, man, that I can't talk bad about, man, that even in his loss, man, I have to respect him because, you know, he was calling Julian J. Rock Williams a tune-up fight. Now, that would be most fighters over at the PBC fighting their life. They're going to try to pick and choose whether they want to fight the kid or not. But in Jarrett Hurd's sense, that was his tune-up fight before he went to go try and unify another belt with Jermell Charlo and trying to grab that WBC, considering he unified with Aries Landry Lara, another guy at 154 that nobody on the PBC tried to fight. You didn't see Jermell trying to unify with Aries Landry Lara. No, Jarrett Hurd had to go do that dirty work. Jarrett Hurd had to go and back clean up. All of these guys that are getting decision wins, speaking on Charlo, getting decision wins on guys like Tony Harrison and guys like Austin Trout. Now, even though we know Melly Mel got the TKO over Tony Harrison the second time, man, Jarrett Hurd has been stopping guys in spectacular fashion for his whole fucking career. That bully style, come forward, show massive aggression, man. Disrespects everybody's punches by walking through them and just literally just giving you the business all day, 24/7, breaking your will. And mind you, this was the guy on the PBC side of the street that was running around collecting all of the belts while Jermell played pussy, sat still, fought a bunch of bums, hoping he would collect them all and have a shot at Jarrett for Undisputed. That is facts. He's the one who unified with Aries Landry Lara, not Jermell Charlo. So truthfully, yes, he does have the he does have the thickest resume at 154. And you know, I would like to see him continue putting his foot on the gas. I would like to see him exercise head movement in his next fight. I want to see what Jarrett's got going on. What has he improved? Because people tend to forget, because Jarrett Hurd lost, you know, they completely try to scrap and throw away everything that he's done. But as soon as Julian Williams gets his fucking head knocked off by Jason Rosario, everybody starts speaking on Jarrett Hurd, his intangibles, and what he possesses. And you start looking at him like, hey, maybe this kid is a special fighter. No, motherfucker, he truly is a special fighter. Now, like I said, we got to see what's going on. He's changed his new trainer, man. To kick aroma, man. So we're gonna see exactly what Jarrett Hurd has implemented into his game plan. My thing is, man, the kid, he has a lot of flow. Yep. People don't know that about him, but Jarrett Hurd does have flow. He's light on his feet, uh-huh. And he can implement head movement, but he's always on the inside, sitting down on his punches, punching people's face in. But the fact that you can't deny his heart, you can't deny he's a Terminator, you can't deny he's not the toughest, you can't deny he's the toughest guy on the PBC.
That's a
you
fact.
Can't deny this kid, man. He does have the best resume at 154. Shit, he's going to continue to do what he was doing before. Keep chasing down belts. Keep taking on the bestest out there and keep proving himself. Because that's what DMV niggas do. We show and prove, Slim. We show and prove. So shout out to Jarrett Hurd for getting back on the ball. Shout out to him for being real enough to knowing that he should take a tune-up fight and not jump into an immediate rematch. You know, because sometimes, man, we got to admit, you know, that, hey, man, we need time to get it right and reformat things. And put that formula together. And that's what he did. Well, that's all I got for you motherfuckers. As we always say, it costs you nothing to pay a nigga no mind. In case y'all motherfuckers forgot, shout out to the real killer over at Premier Boxing Champions, Jarrett Swift Hurd, the 154-pound Thanos, dog. Ain't shit changed. He about to go right back to collecting them motherfuckers. Facts. So get ready, because he coming.
Well, as always, fight fans,
it's the motherfucking boss. Respect, though.